Good morning, everyone. Sorry that the picture and sound is still needs not in sync yet, but good morning and welcome to our Heavenly Parent Holy Community Oceania Hundoke with Reverend Yutaka Yamada. Today being Wednesday, the 4th of August, or the 26th of June in the ninth year of Chong-il Gook. Let's begin, as always, to offer a bow to our heavenly parents and true parents, Chariot Kyombe. Paro. And let's recite our family pledge both in Korean and English. Thank you.
Kajong Mense Yuk Chonguk Chuin Uri Kajogun Cham Sarangul Chunsimago Hanul Pumonimgua 참 부모님의 대신 가정으로서 손을 움직이는 가정이 되어 하늘의 축복을 주변에 연결시키는 가정을 완성할 것을 맹세하나이다.
Family pledge number 6. Our family, the owner of Chong-il Gook, pledges to become a family that moves heavenly fortune by embodying the heavenly parent and true parents and to perfect a family that conveys heaven's blessing to our community by centering on true love. So let's like to ask Jacinta Moreau if she could offer the opening prayer for us.
Okay, good morning, Heavenly Parent. Good morning, our true parents. We gather together as brothers and sisters around our region, greeting you this morning and taking this opportunity to come closer to your heart. And we really want to become your filial sons and daughters. We pray for our true mother at this time, making many preparations to hold a special event at the 30th anniversary of a true parents' visit to North Korea. And we also pray so much for this event that true parents are both longing for, the reunification of their homeland, North and South Korea. We pray that the words that we're here this morning can resonate deeply in our hearts and stay with us during this day and during this week so that we can purify ourselves and become, resemble you more and more as your filial children. I offer this prayer and report in the name of even Jacinta Rowe and all our blessed central families here, Aju.
Thank you. Let's give a warm welcome, as always, to Reverend Yutaka as he shares with us this morning. Thank you.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. Thank you for joining today's Hundoke. How was this morning? Is it a good day? And how was yesterday? And also, how will today and tomorrow, each moment, really see ourselves and our mind, really confidence, comfortable, full with love and passion, or really feel some kind of a nervous and worry, communicating with our heavenly parents and true parents, our heart can catch our heavenly parents' heart in this moment. Really, our heavenly parents, what is your feeling now? Today's happy day, today's nervous day, sad day, exciting day. So in the beginning of the day, yeah, let's communicate and offer our heart to our heavenly parents and true parents, and also share our heart to our old brothers and sisters, and let's begin the new day today. So thank you for joining Hundoke. So let's start today. Yesterday, we share about True Mother's autobiography and talking about true family and also the true love. Mother share many kind of message about the family. If there is harmony, then the happy family can start from that place. So how much harmony we can find in our place and even our society. And also mother share about some sacrificial family story. One son offer his life and protect the father, and also the son was die. This is really sad story, and realistically, still those environment or those situation was happening, is happening in every nation and everywhere. That's why we can see unconditional love and heart and sacrificial life that protect parents, protecting children and die. When we see the newspaper, there every day there are many kind of story. There is good story sometimes to protect then unconditional love, and also many sad story. Parents throw away the children, some put into the car and didn't recognize for 8 hours, 9 hours, even under the sunny summer, strong sunshine day. But parents just play other things, children just inside of a car, and children die. So there is many story, good story, and also bad story. How we can really create ideal society and nation and the world. So family love and family harmony and family heart is really the starting point. That's why mother is sharing. Unconditional love, sacrificial love also can find from the family, and also sad history, problem, and the cause and root is also start from the family. Yesterday, our many brothers and sisters also share your story about your family, your parents, your father and mother, and you see the situation, things. If we are here around 40 or 50 people, then there are same number of family story. If there is the population in the world, then also there are same number of story of our human beings. So among those families, among those peoples, how many couple really we can find with harmonious relationship centering on true love and centering on our heavenly parents and true parents. So let's continue to see the next part of True Mother's autobiography. There are 7.7 billion people on Earth today, but the creation of peace really depends upon two people, one man and one woman. That is a husband and wife. People enter into various types of relationships and encounter different kinds of problems. But the root of all these problems is the same, the flawed relationship between men and women. Peace will come when two people, a man and woman, trust and love each other. If men and women can fulfill their mutual responsibility to trust and love each other, the world will become the happy place we all wish it to be. So mother is talking about 7.7 billion people. So there are many people, but we can divide two type of peoples. What is this? Mother said, men and women. When we see the family, this fundamental relationship is actually between men and women and husband and wife. So how to create harmonious family, how we can create a peaceful relationship. Actually, this starts from relationship between one man and one woman, how we can create. So this is the root of the relationship, root of the happiness. So mother is sharing, even also we are running through Divine Principle lecture. What is the starting point of our human history? This is starting from one man and one woman. But this story is not only inside of the Bible story, even in the current situation. We all story is come from one man and one woman. So if one man and one woman both trust each other, husband and wife, trust each other, love each other, live for sake of others and sacrifice for others, and to take responsibility for each other. Then what's happened in your family? Your family becomes a peaceful family, ideal family, and lovely family. But if father, if husband cannot take responsibility to love, trust, and sacrifice to wife, and wife also cannot take responsibility to husband, and love and doesn't trust each other, then what kind of family will be established? There is no happiness, there is no love, and also there is no joy in that family. If there is no happiness inside the family, or there is no happy family, how about our relative? And also the tribe relationship, this also going to the similar way. That's why if there are many kind of unhappy family in the society and nation, then even our society and nation is going to the same way, unhappy society and also unhappy, miserable nation. That's why Mother is talking about if men and women can fulfill their mutual responsibility to trust and love each other, the world will become the happy place we all wish it to be. That's why the family, of course, our main point of our movement is also same, true family movement. How we can create true family from the early time when we joined this movement. Some of you joined this movement 30 years ago, 40 years ago, 50 years ago. How often, how many times we listen this word to create a happy family, right? We have to become the true husband. We have to become the true wife. And how we can create true family, then we can create through society, nation, and world. We listen many times. We try to be. So how much we fulfill now, we can really reflect ourselves. 50% we fulfill, 70% already we could become the ideal family or still on the way. So this family matter is simple. Everyone know there is family and there is family relationship. But completion of family is really many way to fulfill. So always we can see our family matters. I'm saying that each person's happiness depends on his or her ability to achieve peace in their marriage and family. When true parents, true spouses, and true children form a peaceful family, happiness follows naturally. Harmony is created when parents, children, and grandchildren unite in heart. No matter what difficult come, the parents' heart of love for their sons and daughters and the grandparents' heart of love for their grandchildren should never change. That's why what Mother said about happiness. I am saying that each person's happiness depends on his or her ability to achieve peace in their marriage and family. So this mother's word is really deep. The ability to achieve peace in their marriage and family. This is the point how we can create the happiness, ability to achieve peace in their marriage and family. How this kind of ability do we have now to create peace in our marriage and family? So dear mother is directly mentioning there are many kind of family and there are many kind of problem inside of family when we see the society, even our family relationship between husband and wife, between parents and child, and brother and sisters. So if some children never feel the happiness, never feel the joy and peace inside of their family, what's happened? Really, many people could not feel, could not experience love from parents, could not feel joy from own family, and also cannot feel the touching moment, moving moment inside of the family, then what kind of situation will happen? What kind of situation, what kind of future will happen for these children? When we see the society, we know that divorce rate in the society is more than 50%. This is how much sad things. Children cannot receive love, cannot receive joy from the parents and from the family. Originally, inside the family, parents give the unconditional love, sacrificial love, and children can receive and can grow up inside of those kind of environment about unconditional parents' love, unconditional parents' heart, joy and peace. If children could not have those experience, then is it easy for them to create the happy family and to give the unconditional love and unconditional heart to their spouse and their children or not? That's why mother is really and father is really emphasizing to create the happy family or ideal family, create ideal relationship inside of family. This is the really key point to give the happiness to the next generation, to happiness also the parents figure, even happiness to the grandparents. How we can create, how each family can create those happy family relationship. That's why even father and mother continuously emphasize the importance of family, and this root of the happiness in the family is from one man and one woman, husband and wife. If parents can become the true couple, true parents, and also children become the true children, then this family become the peaceful family, this become the true family, then automatically can learn the peace, can learn and can feel joy, and can continue to the next generation. So mother is talking about even three generations. Parents and child could organize or manifest those family happy relationship, then those happiness automatically going to the grandchildren, then can establish the tradition of true love, love each other, trust each other, and live for each family members, and to going to that our descendants, and expand to our neighbors, our relatives, and also our nation, and also the world. So when we listen this strategy, this word, looks, everyone understand, I think. Everyone agree, everyone understand. Husband, wife love each other, trust each other, sacrifice each other. This is the key point to create ideal family. Everyone, we listen many times, we know that, but how can we fulfill this one? And also parents love children, children love parents. That's why we listen many times. We really can remind how many times we are listening, how many times we are sharing. This is the essence of essence. We can see the root, some kind of roadmap, how to make a peaceful nation and peaceful world, starting from one man, one woman, one couple, one family, and expand and expand and expand. That's why until going to the spiritual world and even going to the next generation, really we will establish to really effort to love my husband, effort to love my wife and parents and children. This fundamental principle never change. And if we can create and expand this family culture and environment from one family, from 12 family, from 120 family, 430 family, and also expanding continuously, this is the really exact route, exact path and the way to create the ideal world. So mother, father emphasize to become the fulfillment of Heavenly Tribal Messiah and Chambo Family Victors. But this is not talking about the number. This is not talking about just the position. We gain this award. We gain this position. Mother and father, true parents is not mentioning about the things. The things is how we can become the true parents inside of family. How we can create true family and how we can create true tribe, true society and nation, and encourage us and guiding continuously. Please become true husband and wife. Please become true father and true mother. Please create true family. This is the root and the central core point of our true family movement, central point of Chambo Family Movement, Heavenly Tribal Messiah Movement. So we, through reading Pundokke and father and mother's message continuously, remind and determine always to create ideal families. Grandchildren also need to respect and love their grandparents. The greatest happiness is generated within the family, where three generations live together in love. Children of true filial piety are those who sacrifice for their parents just as their parents have sacrificed for them. Before striving to be a loyal patriot, each person must first become a filial child before his or her parents, and a sibling who sacrifices for his or her brothers and sisters. So this relationship inside of family, relationship between parents and child, brothers and sisters, this relationship become direct relationship, appear the relationship to appear to the society. Relationship is social relationship, and even the relationship inside of the nation. So parents and child absolutely love and respect and attend each other. And the grandchildren, if grow up among those culture, even grandchildren automatically love parents and grandparents, and respect parents and respect grandparents. So when we think about ourselves, how many couple also living in the three generation together, or even not currently, but in your childhood time or in before, how have you experienced the three generation family relationship? Do you have some experience? You are currently maybe living, or when you are child, your parent generation time, you lived together with three generation. So do we have those experience, direct experience or not? This is really important. When we see the nation, especially the developed country, how about developed country, the situation in the society now emphasize the individual value, individual culture more than family values. So when they stay individually, only parents themselves, or only parent and child themselves, then if time is going, they don't feel the meaning of living together for three generations. And if children grow up under those circumstances, of course, children cannot feel and cannot recognize the happiness and meaning of staying together with three generations, and the value and also the happiness. That's why experience is really important. I believe if you have experience to stay together three generations, of course, in the society, there are many kind of the, even stay together, but there is many fallen nature or selfish society, selfish family. Of course, we cannot see only either family relationship, but you could understand if three generation, four generations stay together, the taste of the family relationship, taste of three generation, four generation, or tribe relationship. Maybe in the island nation, still there is tribe society, not only three generation, maybe four generation stayed together, not only parents and child, even the relatives stayed together, and also many cousins, nephews also living together. Maybe how about Solomon Island? I think Palau society also same, right? Maybe every family come together and live together in the village, and children respect the parents and automatically respect to the grandparents. So my wife is come from Philippines, and my wife's hometown is exactly those family environment. My wife's hometown is the countryside. They are doing the farming. So my wife and also four younger brothers, so total five brother and sisters, and all family is living in the one territory, one place in the village. So if already four or five family is staying together in one same area, that's why if there is children, one family born the have the new children, then all another brothers and sisters love together, and also our grandparents also love together. So when I went there, really many family members stayed together, and grandchildren stayed together, grandchildren also live together. One village is kind of the really same family name. One tribe is really living one village. So automatically, no need to tell, you have to attend to grandparents or grandfather, grandmother. Automatically, parents really respect grandfather and grandmother. That's why grandchildren automatically learning. Otherwise, they will be scored or the attitude, respecting attitude, attending behavior is automatically happening. So how much really beautiful when my Japanese family, my family is only my parents and my brothers and sisters. That's why I didn't experience so much about three generation feeling. But when I went to our Philippines, my wife's hometown, they are really natural. If birthday, one person's birthday, then also all village people, some neighbor or relative come together and sing a song together, and really give the snack to children and give cooking together. Four or five family cooking for one children, cooking for one parents, cooking for one the relatives. So those really natural family relationship is there. That's why three generation, we have experience or not, this is really big differences. When we see those nation, developed nation, of course, maybe financial issue, some technical issue or realistical issue, there is many reason why one generation is convenience or good, but how about ideal strategy, ideal structure of the family? That's why our two parents is emphasizing about the three generation or family culture continuously. So how we can create and how we can experience is really important. So before striving to be a loyal patriot, each person must first become a filial child before his or her parents and siblings who sacrifices for his or her brothers and sisters. So this point is really talking about continuously. The next page, a man or woman becomes a true filial son or daughter when he or she is married. True filial sons and daughters are those who present children to their parents, thereby becoming true parents themselves. The family is the world's most important institution, and Heavenly Parent created it to be the environment of the greatest happiness and goodness. The goodness is because your mother and father are there, and the happiness is because your brothers and sisters are there. So what is the filial son and filial daughters? Mother said, a man or woman becomes a true filial son or daughter when he or she is married. True filial sons and daughters are those who present children to their parents, thereby becoming true parents themselves. So I will read this. I think this point is really important. I will read again. A man or a woman becomes a true filial son or daughter when he or she is married. True filial sons and daughters are those who present children to their parents, thereby becoming true parents themselves. So what is really parents' true happiness? You have maybe son and daughters already. Your son and daughter or our children is growing up, now became the 20 years old and 30 years old and 40 years old. Our children is growing up, but if they don't get married, only just staying a single life, and how about our parents, ourselves? Do we feel the happiness? My son, my daughter, already 30 years old, already 35 years old, already 40 years old, but my son doesn't get blessing, doesn't get marriage. My daughter doesn't get blessing, doesn't get marriage. How about parents' heart? Really can we feel real happiness or not? Maybe some children even doesn't get marriage, but success in the society, become the rich, and also good life, and maybe bring many money to parents and give the many kind of present to the parents. But as the parents, if children doesn't get marriage, how about the heart? Really, can we feel the happiness or not? Real happiness or not? That's why the true mother is mentioning what kind of person is the filial son and filial daughter. That meaning is get married, have a child, and show the child to own parents. This is actually filial son and filial daughters. So you are already kind of the filial son and filial daughter already. So this is the blessing and this marriage, how much important. So the family is the world's most important institution, and heavenly parent created it to be the environment of the greatest happiness and goodness. And also mother said, goodness is because your mother and father are there. And the happiness is because your brothers and sister are there. So mother is mentioning the father and mother is together with us. Husband and wife is together with us. Children is together with us. Looks like so much simple, natural things. We are staying every day together with family. This is really normal, too much normal things. But actually, this is really happy things. You can stay together with husband and wife. Actually, this is really, really happy things. You can stay together with parents and children. This is really happy things. How much we recognize importance of your husband, wife, or those family members. That's why please imagine again and think again about your father, about your mother, about your husband, wife, and your son and daughters, and tell them and talk to them and call them and tell to them to love them. So when you meet your father and mother, please hug them and tell, I love you. And you have a husband, wife, please hug them, hug him, hug her, and please tell, I love you. And if you have son and daughters, please hug them and tell them, I love you so much. And I love my son, I love my daughter, and hug them. This is not any strange things, even you do every day, but continuously, I want to do every day to say love and hug them and also embrace them. This is the real happiness. This is the relationship of love. So how often really are we doing? Really, how often you are saying to, I love you, to your husband and wife? When is the last time to say to your husband and wife, I love you? Can you remember? Maybe your wife, your husband, you remember. I never heard, maybe 20 years ago, I heard one time. Or 30 years ago, I heard one time. We are not those kind of relationship, right? We listen many times from the parents. We have to practice that. So please say, even from today, I love you. And hug them, even kiss them. And if you're living together with your parents, please go to your father, go to your mother, and hug them. And really say, I love you. Or even just only hugging deeply. Then really, how much father and mother will be happy. And if you are living together with your son and daughters, please hug them every day. Hug and tell them, I love you. How much, you know, how much children will be happy. And also how much, if love them, hug them, they are happy, and also myself become happy. And parents happy, husband, wife happy, and children's happy, and become the happy family. So creating ideal family is not kind of the special things from just beside of ourselves. Husband, wife, parents and child, brothers and sisters, love, and also hug, and show and express our heart. So really, Mother is talking about, this is the last page. All people without exception miss their hometown. When we live in a foreign land, our heart aches for our hometown. We miss our nation because our hometown is there. And we miss our hometown because our family is there. That's why if we have a, why we miss the family, why miss the hometown? Because love is there. Family is there. If we creating those kinds of the family relationship always, even love and hug each other, spend time together, respect together, trust each other, sacrifice together, those experience children or we people never forget this happiness, warm heart, and really excitement heart, how we can create the happy relationship from our couple, from parents and child, and from our families. So this chapter, our mother is mentioning and sharing about the love of family, true love of family, happiness in love, happiness in family, and joy in family. So each moment, sentence is really deep and really the important message. Filial son and filial daughter, we are talking about national restoration, the restoration of the world. Of course, we have to do this one, but in the same time, in the individual level or family level, we have to become also true men, true women, true son and true daughter, and the person of true love. This is starting from myself, starting from our family, our place. So today we share about True Mother's message, remind again, connect our heart, and let's practice, and let's create beautiful culture from myself and from my family. Thank you very much once again. Let's have a great day. Kamsahamnida.
Thank you, Reverend Yutaka, as always, you know, very inspirational and, you know, really, you know, helping us clearly understand our true mother's heart and love for us. I was touched by the thought of mutual responsibility. I mean, when I think of mutual responsibility, that means automatically the word mutual means you're thinking about someone else. There's two or more there. You know, it's not a personal responsibility, and mutual responsibility really gives us trust and love. It's when, because you can't trust also means two people or more. Love also means two people or more. So peace only comes when there's that mutual responsibility. that it's the same responsibility carried out by us. And that's why we need gender harmony. That's why we need the relationship between husband and wife to be real. That's why we need harmony between our parents, children, and grandparents. All of this brings peace and harmony. So this two words, mutual responsibility, is filled with so much meaning. And I just remember in my own family upbringing, being a Greek family and extended families, when we would gather for our annual Christmas gathering, I mean, all the families would come together, all the kids and grandkids would be there, it was always very happy. Sometimes when I was young and all the family got together, it wouldn't just be one day, it'd be like 3 days worth of celebration together, because we haven't seen each other for the year and come from all over Australia, we would just enjoy each other's company. And I remember my father saying that his job and part of Greek tradition was that the parents' job wasn't complete until their children married, until their all the kids were married and they had their own kids. And so mother's sort of saying the same thing, a true filial son and daughter, it isn't complete until they marry and have children and offer the grandchildren up to the parents to love. So, and the other thing that struck me, mutual responsibility is one thing. And the other thing was that parents represent goodness and siblings represent happiness. And I found that very interesting, because when I grew up, I saw them as the ones that administered the rules and laws. I mean, yes, we grew up, my parents didn't spare the rod. We got hit when we were bad. And so, yes, they represented the ideal of what they thought was good. And then when that was all over, even though it was a bitter pill to take, it was, we kids would go out and we would just play together and we'd be happy and we'd create all these games and adventures together. That experience of parents as goodness and siblings as a place of happiness, I felt that growing up. Those were the two main takeaway things for me: mutual responsibility, and parents represent goodness and siblings represent the source of happiness. So thank you, everyone. We have opportunity to share. Who would like to share their reflection or thought? Yes. Yes, no, go ahead.
Yeah. Good morning, everyone. Today's kind of still related to yesterday's reading, okay. And I thought yesterday, I have a really, really beautiful experience with my grandfather who had raised me up. I grew up with him. He passed away maybe early 2000s, I think, and in the very beginning, it was always difficult. I would always be very emotional talking or even just the mention of his name. So it really doesn't matter how long it could. It stays with you forever. Beautiful experience. In the late 70s, I decided to take full care of my grandparents, and because they were, he was in his 80s, and he was my healer. It was very healing for me because, although he was getting old, a bit forgetful, but it's so funny when he watched TV, every time he wakes up, he would just say, let's pray. The beginning of everything was pray. So, of course, he would doze off. Old people doze off a lot, right, when they're watching TV. So so many times I would have to say prayers with him. There wasn't many people around. It was just him and I and my grandmother and sometimes my son. But he was like, I really felt, I really understood the relationship between God and a child, because he was very much like my my God. I really, he stood in the position of God for me, you know, in person, because he was. He was a person of love, because I've never really had ever been told off by my grandfather. Never. He never wronged me. He has never saw fault in me. And even though perhaps I think he may have been a bit disappointed in me leaving home, joining the church, but he's never said it to me. He's never made it that he was disappointed either. But he did say that if it was a good thing, it would last. That gave me encouragement. Because I had a difficult time in the late 70s, you know, a long time. It was quite healing to be with him. I just wanted to share that beautiful experience that I had with my grandfather. Thank you.
Yes, Reverend Ito, go ahead.
Thank you very much, Reverend Ito Kazu. Messages regarding family and ancestor and hometown, because since I'm a missionary and is 20s and now I'm 70, close to 50 years I'm overseas. I'm a first son. I never met my mother's death and my father's death. You know, the funeral time, I was a foreign country, and I have no chance to, no money suddenly, to back to Japan to attend the funeral. And my younger brother took care and both parents. So I really felt, the family issue. Now, because of COVID, I'm in Japan, over close to 50 years, I never ever lived even 1 year in Japan. And now 1.5 years, close to 2 years, I living in my country, So I thought, this is Japan. This is my home country, And last year, my son drive me to my hometown, Akita City, in Akita, and I visited the ancestors and the, a graveyard, and met relatives, and become getting old. Already father, mother is not there. And anyway, I really felt, this is my country, my hometown now, And really, look like a story of, Robinson Crusoe, or Treasure Island, with, isolated place. Well, you see that in Papillon, like this. Eh? And in Japan, there's Urashima Taro, those men with the torture together go to the, Kingdom of Heaven under the sea, and he enjoy with many with the king and the queen in the sea, just like a Marshall Island. Externally nothing, but inside of the sea there is a great kingdom. Just like when you're diving, you can see you know, very beautiful. So, but external and almost nothing, you know, no land, you know, something, you know, like we are, you know, 50 years, close to 50 years overseas, you know, and when come back, already everybody gone, you know, some, you know, classmate become a bit old man, old woman, and no more parents. And I visited where I was grown up, the place where school or elementary school I visited when I was there, or kindergarten, you know, but, you know, complete change, you know. So really I felt, you know, ancestors and the hometown, et cetera, because it's so long years overseas and with God together, you know. And now because of COVID, I stay close to now 1.5 years. I very thank you so much, you know. I cannot back to, you know, easy back to Marshall Island, but I can watch now Japan. For me, Japan is, you know, very, you know, interesting place. Not, you know, looks like a foreign country, but my try to find out, this is my country, native country, you know. Yeah, and now, you know, every day is Olympic, is very so busy, like the watching. But, you know, yeah, looks like, you know, I look from outside always. But when I live there here, you know, and now I get the driver license in Japanese, you know, well, with so many strict everything, you know, everything strict way. But Africa and the Pacific, the nation about, no, I'm sorry to say, about everything about, you know, no exact time. Anyway, Africa is more about. Pacific is a little more about. Japan is completely exact, you know, like a, you know, train, even the freight train, you know, even the train is even 1 second, you know, 1 minute, never mistake. Yeah, very exact place, you know. And completely about, you know, when we meet, I invite them, oh, you come to for dinner tomorrow? Oh, yes, he said, but never coming, because he said yes to everybody. So first yes, he forgot. So must remind again, many times in Marshall Island, many times, you know, their yes is not complete yes, because if they say no, very, you know, not so polite, so they say yes, even they feel no. So we must, you know, many times, you know, Africa also many times greeting, you know, stop the car and get out from even busy and greeting. Yeah. Not that that's, how I cannot say like this, you know. So greeting is more important than, you know, the business, you know. Anyway, but by this, you know, I can really understand, you know, what's hometown, you know. I'm very sorry to my parents, couldn't attend the funeral and ancestors, you know. So I really, you know, this moment after 70s, I am now, you know, watching my country. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Reverend Ito. Thank you. We have our time is up. I'm having trouble still with the audio, so I'll just play the sound for our unison prayer. So I'll just begin it. Let's begin. Thank you. Adieu. Thank you, everyone. Have a great day and see you tomorrow. Okay, bye bye.
God bless everyone.
Yeah, God bless.
Thank you, Na, for the wonderful testimony. Yeah.
Thank you.
Na.
You're welcome. Yeah. Bye.
Bye. Bye.